Can you lift your hands everywhere? Lift it because you know you are lifting it before the King of Kings in honor and in reverence to the presence of Jesus that is in this place. Please lift your hands everywhere. It's a sign of surrender. It's a sign of surrender to Him. And in 60 seconds, can you talk to Him and tell Him to have His way in your life? Let Him do what only Him can do. Let Him do what He desires to do in your life. Can you forget about who is around you with your hands lifted? And can you talk to your Maker? It's noisy. Can you talk to Him? Do what you want to do tonight. I came for an experience. I didn't just come for service. I came for an encounter. Can you be serious in your prayer everywhere and online? Can you forget about every distraction around you and talk to the Father of Spirits? Lord, I need you to do something mighty, something tangible, something magnificent, such as never seen or heard. I lay aside my ambition. I lay aside my agenda. Have your way. This is me. We feel the rain of your Lord. We feel the wind of your Spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. Keep talking to Him. Feel the rain of your Lord. We feel the wind of your Spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. We feel the rain of your Lord. We feel the wind of your Spirit. Now the heartbeat of heaven, let us hear. So let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven and let it rain.
Let it rain.
Let it rain.
Open the floodgates. Your presence. I need the rain of your Spirit again.
Let it rain.
In the midst of a trying testimony.
Open the floodgates. Floodgate of heaven.
Let it rain. To rain upon your life, the rain of His presence, the rain of His favor, the rain of His grace, the rain of His glory, the rain of His all sufficiency. Of heaven, Let it rain.
Can you just soak in His presence? The Lord in the midst of His people is mighty. If you believe He's here tonight, can you reach out to Him? Can you cry out to Him in your own words? Speak to Him in psalms, in hymns. Speak to Him in the Spirit. Open up your mouth. Reach out to the heavens. Reach out to the rain of His glory. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Healing rain is calling now. Healing rain is falling now. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid. Healing rain is falling down. Healing rain is falling down. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid. Healing
rain is falling down.
Healing rain
is falling down.
The rain that is able to heal.
I'm not afraid.
The rain that transforms.
I'm not afraid.
The rain that breaks you.
Healing rain is falling down.
Healing rain is falling down. Reach out to Him tonight.
I'm not afraid.
Can you reach out to Him tonight? Can you cry out for a fresh touch? Can you cry out for a visitation? It was never designed that you will go back the same when you come to the presence of the Lord. It was never designed. They go from strength to strength. Each one that appears before Him in Zion. It was never designed that you go back the same. Can you cry for something new? Can you reach out to Him for something fresh? Can you reach out to Him tonight? Say ananana. Sing to Him in other tongues. Sing to Him in the language of the Spirit. Say Arambra na 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 na. It's an experience with Him tonight. Jesus.
Jesus. Fill this room with your presence. Reach out to your children. Touch every heart. Change every life tonight. Breaking tonight. Burdens are being lifted. Get ready to step into a new dimension.
a new level. Greater experiences await you. And I looked and I saw a door open in heaven. And I heard a voice said unto me, come up here. Get ready for a shift, says the Spirit of the Lord. Lord, we give you praise. Jesus, we lift up your name. 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 Jesus. For when we behold him, we are changed. For when we behold him, we are changed. We are transformed from glory to glory as by his Spirit. From glory to glory. Jesus. Thank you, Father. Lord, tonight we ask you to have your way. We ask that you bring forth your word to us with life. We ask that everyone here and online will be saturated with your presence. We ask for a heavy and a tangible manifestation of your glory. Can you lift your hands everywhere? Oh, I sense the move of the Spirit now. I see at least 7 to 14 people now. And the Lord is saying, a weight of his glory is about to rest upon you. A heavy weight of his glory is coming upon your life. It will be heavy. It will be something you cannot contain. And right now I see the angel of the Lord moving across this hall. Father, I pray, both to those on ground and to those online, mark those 7 to 14 people and let them experience right now a tangible weight of your glory upon on their lives. Let it rest upon them. Let it rest upon them strong. Let it rest upon them strong. A heavy weight of your power. A heavy weight of your glory. Your life will never remain the same. Take that measure of his glory right now. Take it now, everywhere. Take it now. Take it now. From today, step into a level of divine experiences. Experiences such as you have never seen before. Let the cloud and the fire of his presence rest upon your life mightily. Strange things that the Lord is doing tonight. Lord, breathe upon your people tonight, I pray. Oh, I feel the heavy weight. I know what I'm telling you right now. I feel the heavy weight. It's like a cloud that is moving all across this hall. And they were baptized into Moses in the cloud. And they were baptized into Moses in the cloud. And they were baptized into Moses in the cloud. Thank you, Father. Let your name be exalted. In Jesus' mighty name. If you can, just be seated if you can. Except those who are under the anointing of the presence of God. Just leave them. Those who are under the manifestation of the presence, just leave them until God is done with them. But if you can, just be seated briefly. Please, if you can't pay attention for a few minutes, I'd like you to understand that the name Pneumatech is more than just a name. It's more than just the name of a service. Pneumatech is an experience. When the Lord Jesus manifests himself amongst his people, there are three things that you must expect amongst many other things. Number one, his presence is revealed. His presence. For in his presence is the fullness of joy. His presence brings all of heaven into a particular atmosphere. It is the presence of God that can guarantee that you will not go back the same. It's not the sermon you listen to necessarily. It's the presence of God that you make contact with per time. There is energy, divine energy inseminated in his presence that is capable of changing your life and bringing it to conform to the very image, plan and purpose of God designed for you by time. It's his presence. Number two, you must experience his wisdom because he will speak. Jesus is the word of God manifested. And when he speaks, he opens us to the wisdom of Elohim. He opens us to the wisdom by which the Lord founded the earth. The wisdom by which the earth was established without pillars. The wisdom of the ancients. The wisdom that is mysterious in itself, yet was appointed for our glory. And then the third thing that you must experience is his power. When that power is released, it breaks yokes, it undoes heavy burdens, it sets free the captives. It has the ability to bring men into a place of liberty, the liberty of the sons. You don't need to tell the power of God what to do. Just seated in an atmosphere that contains the power of God is enough. Even the things that you never thought were in your life, that were impediments to your advancement, both in God and in life, they come under the heavy judgment of God's power. And when you walk out of this place, you know, like Jacob, that you have met with God. And he said to Jacob, like a prince, you have had power with God and with men, and you have prevailed. And that's what I want us to be conscious of every time we come. Be conscious of the fact that you will experience his wisdom revealed to you through the scriptures. Be conscious of the fact that you will experience his presence capable of transforming your very life. And be conscious of the fact that you will make contact with his power. It is that power that will accelerate you into another place in destiny. With that in mind, I want you to be very, very, very sensitive. Tonight, I will beg you in the name of God, if it is not necessary, don't move. If it is not necessary, don't walk up and down. Make sure you are seated, listening with your ears and your heart, opening your spirit for what God is about to do. It's not the name of a service that makes it a special service. It's the faith of the people ready for God to do something new that makes it a special service. Tonight can just be your night. Tonight can just be a date that you will save in destiny. Tonight can be the night that you met with God and something radically was altered in your existence. Friends, I welcome you to Pneumatech, and to those streaming online, I trust that you will have the same equal experience that we are having here in the name of Jesus Christ. The consciousness of His presence. That's the teaching for tonight. The consciousness of His presence. The consciousness of His presence. Matthew chapter 28. The consciousness of His presence. Lord, breathe upon us tonight. Can you pray in the spirit just while you are seated? Briefly, there's something happening right now. I'm seeing a vision. Something is happening now. Can you just speak in other tongues if you can, where you are seated? And if you can, do it out loud. There's a shift going on in the realm of the spirit. There's a shift. There's a shift. You see what I'm talking about? Please pray. Forget about what's happening around you. Please pray. Please pray. Participate in what God is doing. Don't just look around. Make sure you are a participant. Hallelujah. Now I'm seeing a vision, and thank God you guys are stationed, because something is going to happen. This afternoon I saw a man of God, a mentor of mine, and he was giving me a sign. And I know what that sign is. Now right now I feel the anointing. It will come upon a few people and they will literally jump out of their seat and begin to run. Right now, it will happen in 10 seconds. The anointing will come on some people and they'll jump out of their seat and begin to run. Just help them. Just help them. It will happen in 10 seconds. It's an anointing for speed. It's an anointing for speed. Right now, as I count to 10, anything that has held down your destiny, I release the grace for speed. Speed, speed, speed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Divine acceleration. Divine acceleration. Wait, I'm still seeing three to four people. It's still coming. And I'm seeing the anointing around this place at the center. I'm seeing the anointing around this place. Take it. Help him. Divine acceleration. Anything that has held you down, anything that has crippled your advancement, from today, let that impediment be rolled away. Step into speed. Please just help them and make sure you are not distracted, please. You are the God who was and is to come. Jesus. Jesus. In you I trust, my life is in your hands. Jesus,
You are the miracle working God. You are Yahweh. 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 Alpha and Omega. You are Yahweh.
Asking me to still make that prophecy again. I declare divine acceleration and speed, 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 speed. I break the chains that have held you. Step into unusual acceleration. Let every area of your life experience the speed of the Most High. You are Yahweh, Alpha. God is doing something in this service. Make sure you participate. You are Yahweh,
Alpha, Omega.
Listen to this. You are the Lord. You change now. You are the Lord who changeth not. 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 Sing it one more time.
You are the Lord who changeth not.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord who changeth not.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord
who changeth not. Change. You are the Lord You remain the same. Listen, you'll catch it again. You will never, never change. You are the Lord. You remain the same. You will never, never change. You are the Lord. You will never change. One more time, you will never change.
You will never, never change.
You are the Lord.
You will never, never change.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord. You will never
say. You will never, never
you
change.
You will never,
never
change.
You are the Lord.
You
the voices. You will never, never, never,
you will never, never change.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord. You remain the same.
You will never, never, never,
never
change. Lift your hands, whether you are seated or you are standing. You will never, never. That's who you are, the unchangeable changer.
You are the Lord.
It says, I am the Lord God, I change not. Therefore,
you
sons of Jacob are not consumed. You will never, never change. Chapter 28, under the same atmosphere, let's get to the word briefly. Activations are going on in the realm of the spirit. Activations are going on right now. Divine activation. An activation simply means God coming to kickstart something that has been dead, or coming to increase the capacity or the impact of something that has been. And as I speak right now, I see two people that the hand of the Lord is coming upon. God is anointing your tongue. From today, He is going to begin to give you divine utterance. Divine utterance. That's what the Spirit of God is saying. And this anointing is for the prophetic Spirit to rest upon you. You will have the ability to communicate the things that the Lord shows you. Now, I want you never to be distracted. I will teach and God will minister at the same time. This service is just going to be as God wants it. Jesus. You know why I'm quiet? I'm seeing something happening. That's why you see these manifestations. I'm seeing something happening. Now, I'm looking for a song to sing what I'm seeing. That's why you see me quiet. I'm looking for a song that has to do with fire, because I just saw fire upon some people now. So I'm looking for a song that has to do with fire. It will rest on at least 10 people. 10. That's what I'm seeing. 10. Fresh fire. That's what I'm seeing. But I'm looking for a song. And the cymbals.
Holy Spirit, we wait on you.
Oh, fire, fire,
fire.
Upon that prayer altar, upon that prayer altar, let fresh fire fall. Let fresh fire fall. Now. There are a lot of angelic activities going on right now. Right now, God is rekindling the fire on altars, prayer altars, altars of fasting, altars of sacrifice, altars of devotion, altars of consecration that has grown cold. Right now, the fire from the throne room rest upon those altars. Set it ablaze. And from today, begin to burn on another level. From today, be set ablaze. Be set ablaze. For those of us that are new here, I apologize. This is what we call the ministry of the Spirit. I'm not guessing. Something is happening. I'm just helping to pilot what God is doing. Wait. There's somebody listening online from another state. And as I speak now, the fire of God is coming on you. You are online. You begin to feel heat on your right.